place is so shiny. Eh? Oh, that's Sam. Yo.
Pathfinder, Captain Dunn said to steal your father's cabin from anyone but you. It's open now.
Well, thanks, guy.
Sam? What was that?
An eidetic trigger, related to your father, and the portions of my memory array he locked.
What triggered it?
Alec tied it to your progression as Pathfinder, not to a location. Puzzling as it may be, my programming is clear. Locating more of these triggers will unlock the memories. One of your father's memories is now accessible. Return to Sam Node on the Hyperion to investigate further.
Coffee machine Mom got for Dad. He was so busy designing you. Needed the caffeine.
I did not realize I owed my existence to a bean.
And now you know what humility feels like.
Aw, cute!
What's on here, Sam?
Your father's personal logs. Several of them are encrypted.
Sorry, archaeologist! What?!
Sam. This is a reminder about Dr. Liara Tassoni. She's an Asari archaeologist I corresponded with a few years back. She's got experience studying ancient cultures. Make sure the team gets her research. Could be useful in Andromeda.
Liara Tassoni, huh? She studied the Protheans. When my team used to dig up artifacts, we'd debate her work. She had some pretty controversial theories, as I recall. Never gained much traction.
I have loaded Dr. Tassoni's research onto datapads.
Wow.
Hello, Alec. This is Dr. Tassoni. I'm flattered you contacted me. Most scientists dismiss my work, but I'm young and Asari, and they are getting older. So we will see who has the final word. In the meantime, I'm happy
they got
to
the
pass
voice
along
actress.
My research. I hope your team finds it useful.
Okay.
Hello, Alec. I received your message. I must say, the thought of exploring another galaxy has my head spinning. I am honestly not sure how people could survive a trip like that. And anyway, I could not bear to leave the Milky Way behind. There is so much about the Protheans I still hope to learn here. So much potential wisdom to tap. I wish you much good luck and future success.
Well, thanks.
The day is finally here. We're pushing off from Earth. We'll jump through a few relays first, then we hunker down for the long trip across dark space. It's daunting thinking about all the hopes and dreams aboard the Hyperion. I certainly have my own. I wasn't the husband or father I should have been. Here's hoping 600 years can change a man.
Well, great! Great!
Dunn's agreed to a scouting mission on Habitat 7. I'm gearing up now. I'm worried about Scott. Dr. Tapero says he'll be fine, but he's my son. How can I not worry? I hate to leave him like this. It's these moments when you wish you told your children you love them more often. Or ever. Which brings me to the tough part. Kids, if anything happens to me, there are things you're gonna find out. I hope you'll understand.
Well, okay.
That log is not currently accessible.
Okay.
Unlocking my
well then, okay, bye-bye, Dad. It was good talking to you. It was good crying a little bit.
I am Dr. Liara Tassoni, and I've spent several decades researching ancient Protheans. It is common knowledge that the Protheans
Dang,
were an
this is weird to hear
race
her voice.
That flourished in the Milky Way about 50,000 years ago, then went extinct. Even at the time of this writing, the year 2182, their culture remains a mystery. During my studies, I have developed some practices that can be used when analyzing any ancient culture.
Oh.
I hope they may prove useful for the research community.
Gimme? Gimme?
When studying a dead race, The most obvious problem is the lack of an
observable population. This is like my roots!
This raises the question, when is a species truly extinct? The Prothean civilization spanned the galaxy, and it took centuries to confirm that all members of the species really had died out. While it's possible that living Protheans may be found in a hidden pocket of the galaxy one day, the chances are statistically trivial. Once an extinction is confirmed, the study's nature moves from sociology to exoarchaeology.
Yeah, makes sense. Okie dokie. Anything else? Any other audio excerpts that you can give me that will be useful in me doing this? Oh, what? Oh! I'm gonna cry! That was the SSV Normandy! It was the SR2! Oh my gosh! I'm gonna cry! That was so beautiful! I've got tears in my eyes. Jeez Louise. Man. Not pulling any punches, game, aren't ya? Sidearm.
Your father's first sidearm. A memento of his early Alliance service.
I bet that saw plenty of action.
Alec's first kill occurred in combat during the First Contact War.
Back when Turians were the enemy. Crazy times.
Alright. Oh. Books.
Printed books?
Reproductions of Lewis and Clark's journals. Detailing their expedition in the 19th
century. Those aren't books, they're like...
Explains Dad's interest. They were Pathfinders, too.
They're like notepads.
When studying an extinct race, it is important that our preconceptions and current knowledge not color the facts. We must look to the evidence itself. The Protheans constructed the Citadel.
They didn't,
and an
actually.
Incredible network of mass effect relays. This speaks to a culture of the highest order. Such a monumental achievement surely must come from an enlightened race that was in harmony with its people.
See, she tells us to not color it, and then she colors it.
Without the ability to study a living example, however, this can never be determined with 100% accuracy.
Nice. Can I go? I'm gonna look it up in a second if I can't figure it out. I'm gonna look up how to see my brother.
Ryder, the blocks your father placed on my array are opening. I can now recall specific memories which Alec wanted you
he's
to
like
see.
He's like a Nautilus, too.
Wait, I can actually see his memories?
Yes, you will experience them via your implant.
I don't know if I want that.
Okay, something new every day. Let's see it.
This memory is from the time when your father was posted on the Citadel.
Alec, your recommendations will never fly. Artificial intelligence?
Oh yeah, she was the first human ambassador.
It's our best option.
If the Council gets wind of this, it'll set humanity standing back decades. You're overreaching.
Ambassador Goyle, I'm the military attaché on the Citadel. My mandate is clear. Find an edge for Earth.
And AI is your answer?
We need to catch up. The Asari, the Salarians, they're centuries ahead of us.
But it's illegal.
Their rules, not ours. Why deny Earth an advantage?
Define this advantage.
It will set us free. We're prisoners of our own five senses. There's a reality greater than ours that we can't perceive, but an AI can.
How?
By augmenting our own abilities and adding a few new ones.
Well, none of that stopped those Geth from revolting.
Because they were separate from their creators. But AIs and humans interface directly, experiencing the world together, benefits both.
Sort of a synthesis
There's
ending.
There's no creator to revolt against.
I'm sorry, Alec. We can't take the risk. I appreciate your work, but your request will be denied.
Alec?
Ellen, what did the doctor say?
He told me to appreciate the time I have left. There's no cure, Alec. It's terminal.
She's gonna tell me that.
On my watch.
She's gonna tell me that over the video.
Wow, hearing Mom again. I never knew that's how Dad found out.
Yeah, that was kind of a punch in the face.
I would hope so. Mom's life was worth fighting for.
It would seem his obstinance extended to me as well.
Nobody wanted to listen. The idea of you scared people too much. After this, Dad moved us back to Earth to care for Mom. Wonder why he wanted me to see this.
Perhaps it was the beginning.
Of what?
Unknown. Private audio logs are now available in your father's quarters. I detect additional memories, but they are currently locked. They may yet hold answers.
Okay, I'll keep working on it.
Oh, brother!
Do you know anything more about Scott's condition?
I monitor Dr. Carlisle's reports. He is providing Scott with the very best care possible. I'm afraid there is nothing more to be done at this time.
Can I go see him?
What more can you tell me about my implant?
The implant itself provides me with direct access to your senses. I can see, hear, and experience the same stimuli you do while in the field. This raw data enables me to provide real-time feedback and analysis of the situation.
Then Dad added the secret sauce.
He removed the restrictions on my access to Pathfinder physiology.
Uh-huh. Just promise you won't fry my brain or anything?
Trust is an important concept in any relationship. Alec taught me that. I will not fry your brain. It would end badly for
me more than you.
I actually, when I first heard about Sam, my initial response was, can I romance the AI? So this is interesting that he is so fused with me. That'd be interesting.
I take it you're based here in Samnode?
Correct. This is where my core processing unit resides. However, using quantum entanglement communication, I remain in constant touch with you and the Pathfinder mission team, even over great distances.
What are your capabilities?
Each arc houses a SAM, simulated, adaptive, matrix. Each is an artificial intelligence designed by Alec Ryder to support Pathfinders and their teams.
So they're different SAMs, or they have the same SAM?
But AI is illegal in the Milky Way. How did my dad get around that?
Exceptions were made. The initiative deemed his research vital to the mission. Our design was conducted in secret.
Yeah.
So there are other SAMs out there?
Correct. However, your father continued to modify my own routines until the Hyperion's departure. I am the most advanced SAM in the initiative.
Of course.
What did he mean by a symbiotic relationship?
Symbiosis is a mutually beneficial relationship
between
two life forms. A flower provides nectar to a bee, who in turn provides pollen for the flower. The bee gains nourishment, and the flower can propagate. In similar fashion, my own evolution was shaped by your father's experiences, and will now expand with yours. In return, I provide you with capabilities and analysis beyond normal human faculties. We each benefit.
Okie dokie.
That's all for now.
Of course.
Back to Dad's room like a creeper.
Your father's personal logs.
Ah.
Amazing how life can change in an instant. Suddenly my career doesn't matter. This incredible woman I've been married to all these years. She's facing the end. All I think about are the times I wasn't there for her. Well, that's going to change. It occurs to me that Sam might be more than I ever imagined.
So he was going to try to integrate Sam with his wife to save her. I mean, can I do that, like, right now, or? I don't think so. So we can go to the tram, operations center, and the habitat. Where's the how do I get to the habitation? I am on the habitation deck. Where's my brother? That's Dad's room. That's Sam's room. Well, I'm thinking that the opening of memories is going to be something that happens throughout the game. Oh, I need to find my phone because I need to look up. It's like tempting to not though because I don't want, you know, spoilers, but. It's actually, surprise, surprise, not telling me. The game's been out for too soon. People haven't started forums up yet asking questions and stuff. There is obviously no way for me to get anywhere else, though, on the ship. Maybe I gotta get Tempest first. I'm gonna save. I haven't saved yet. I'm a fiend. I am ridiculous. I mean, I'm keeping my eyes peeled, but I do not see any other way in the area. Basically, I can only go to Dad's room and the tram. I like the variety of outfits. Okay, well, off I go, I guess. Bye! Wait, where do I go for my ship? Okay. Well, let's go get the ship! What? Docking bay? Cryo bay? Oh! Take me to the cryo bay! I was just pressing it. I didn't realize that there were different locations you could go to. This makes more sense! Bro! Broski! My bro! Bro, wake up! We can still see the Scourge out there? I thought it went away. Bro! Broski, we need a brewski!
I'll make it right, Dash. I promise. Pathfinder, I'm Nigel McCoy. Just got out of cryo.
Welcome to Andromeda, Nigel.
Thank you. It's bittersweet, though. My little brother Dash was stationed on the Nexus. I just learned he died on Eos, trying to start a settlement.
That's awful. I'm sorry, Nigel.
Yeah. We were gonna start families up here together. I have a pendant our father wore. Dash had its match. Will you reunite them?
Of course.
In his digital journal, he mentioned a spot on Eos where he'd go to think. If you could leave the pendant there.
Okay. How's it going?
Fisher, glad to see you're doing better.
How's your head?
That was some expedition, hey? Captain said I'm going in the log as the first human to make contact with the Ket. And Kirkland's the first casualty. Wish it could have gone differently.
I'm sure there are decent aliens here in Andromeda, too. We just have to find them.
Well, I heard you're Pathfinder now. The sooner you figure out where they're hiding, the better.
Will do. Chin up.
I want to find me some new aliens! Greer, how's it going?
Greer, how you feeling?
Grateful. If you and Liam hadn't found me in that cave, God knows what those aliens would have done.
We couldn't leave a man behind.
Yeah, your father, Kirkland.
I'll never forget their sacrifice. It's a brave thing, risking your life for the greater good.
Yeah, just seems unfair. We barely got here.
I know, bro!
I'm sorry I'm not out there with you, but Kirkland was a friend, and I'm not cut out for this anymore.
Understood. Habitat 7 was a nasty wake-up call. You take care, Greer.
You too. Thanks again.
Ryder.
Hayes, how's the wound?
Doc says I'll live. So, this goes from a life-threatening gunshot to a story I'll tell my grandkids someday.
With no need to exaggerate, That was a tough fight on Habitat 7.
Just glad to be on the other side of it.
Is that my brother?
I see you. Damn shame about your dad, though. I'm sorry we couldn't save him.
I'm sure you did everything you could.
Yeah, but still, we lost a Pathfinder on my watch. Doesn't sit
You look different, not in the
my
animation.
My dad knew the danger. Part of the job.
Now I just need to make sure your brother here pulls through.
How's Scott doing?
His condition's stable. I see signs of REM activity in the brain, so he's dreaming. Means all the wiring still works.
He's gonna wake up to a nasty
How'd
surprise.
This happen?
It was dumb luck, really. We hit the scourge at the worst possible moment, just as the stasis revival was kicking in. It's a vulnerable moment, coming out of a 600-year nap, then wham! Circuits fried and overloaded the neural pathways. Don't worry, I'm on it. We're not losing another rider.
Are you staying here in the Hyperion?
You know that moment when you realize you're just getting too old? Right, look who I'm talking to. Trust me, it happens. For me, it was Habitat 7. Watching you guys running around, dodging lightning and the cat, it's a young man's game. Pains me to admit it, but it's passed me by.
Oh, come on, buddy.
We'll miss you, Harry.
Just make sure to raise some hell once in a while, will you? I'm living vicariously through you.
Deal.
Okie dokie.
How did you end up with the initiative?
Well, you reach a point in life where you wonder, is that all there is? I'd accomplished everything in the Milky Way I could. I was locked into a future of diminishing returns. So coming here was the world's biggest midlife crisis. A chance to wake up in the morning and feel hope instead of our
Dude, I love you.
That's all, Harry. Thanks.
Don't be a stranger. If anything changes with Scott, I'll let you know.
Scott, I'm sorry I didn't spend as much time on your face as I did on mine, but you're gonna be beautiful. You already look beautiful, bro, and you're breathing. And I'm really sorry that I couldn't help our dad. Sorry about that. All right, well, I'm gonna check out the tram a little more thoroughly. Jeez. I wish they would, like, you know, give you a little more direction. Like, as to what I'm doing. That's the docking bay. Can we go anywhere? We can go to the docking bay, we can go to the habitation deck, and we can go to operations. And the cryo. That's where we're at. So let's go to the docking bay! So my bro. Hi, Cora!
Ready to see what Tan gave us? I hear it's something special. Pathfinder en route. How's the ship?
In final checks, looking great.
We won't be long. The way things are going, we'll be on our own out there.
In other words, we're making this up as we go.
We used to call that tactical improvisation. But at least we'll be doing it in style.
Gimme, gimme.
They call her the Tempest.
Ooh, look at my face! Oh, man. Oh, I'm already in love. Between a woman and her machine. Oh my gosh. Wow. She's so streamlined.
Let's go take a closer look.
And they just gave her to us?
Let's pick it up a bit, people. We're 14 months late.
Petra! You're my girlfriend.
So you're the one who's making everything.
I'm in love!
Petra. Petra Nix. Initiative wrangler, provisioner, gunner, and everything in between.
Please? Oh my
Are
gosh.
Are we ready? The sooner we get out of here, the better.
Oh, what?
You're coming with us?
Yes. Otherwise, there's no way they're letting this ship off the station.
What? Well, I kind of want to ask what's wrong, but I also want to say, let's do it. Maybe I'll say my rider's a bit too. She's obviously, she's either staring right at Vetra's chest or staring just past her to the ship. And if she's anything like me, she's going to be staring straight at the ship, because that's your true love right there. Your ship never lets you down.
Yeah, let's go see the rest of Helios.
That was not very enthusiastic.
Hold it, hold it. You're not going anywhere.
Damn it.
Whatever happened, it wasn't me. I just got here.
Director Addison wants to see a complete report of the Tempest supplies, munitions, and crew.
Director Tan overruled Addison.
The ship's loaded out with equipment for outpost discovery, squarely under Director Addison's purview.
Seen you around. Ben, right?
Ben, look at that swagger!
Ben, didn't you? Son still in cryo? I could pull some strings, get him to the front of the line.
Really?
Yeah, really.
They told me he wasn't essential, but I miss him.
I know. I got family too, Ben.
It's done. Addison's gonna kill me.
Smooth.
Nicely done.
Part of the job, Pathfinder. All things considered, it was an easy ask. And right now, you need people tearing down obstacles, not putting up more.
I love you. I love you! Come back!
Finally, someone who cares about doing stuff and not just talking about it.
Yay! Cora likes her too! Oh, man! Your voice too? I'm in love. You see that swagger too? She walked like sassy. Sassy walk.
Everything's state of the art. Labs, sensors, exploration gear. Plus her crew, of course. The best in their field.
Ah, glad to see you looking well.
What? I've seen you before, right?
The engine core is based on the Ark's Odyssey drive.
It runs a hell of a lot quieter.
That's Gil Brody.
Gil!
Engineer, mechanic, all-around wrench jockey.
He's not a romance available for a female, but that's
room.
Okay.
There's space for upgrading equipment, gathering intel.
Router engaged. Securing connection to Tempest.
Welcome aboard, Sam. And Ryder, of course.
Oh, yes! Scottish!
Suvi Anwar, our science officer. Your quarters are below. Plenty of space up here to get everyone together. It's all yours.
Vetra knows what
light,
she's doing.
Stealthy, and the fastest ship in her class.
Who are you? You are just... You're amazing! I like how that her armor looks worn, too.
It's really going to be something, isn't it?
I haven't even shown you the best part.
Wait.
When you're ready to fly, over to the bridge. Our pilot should have everything good to go.
You are the best person in my life right now. You're giving me the one thing that I didn't even realize she was going to give me the ship.
Yeah, we're excited.
I turned the film grain off.
Head to the bridge when we're ready to go.
I turned the film grain off. Why is there like a film grain looking thing now all of a sudden? Yeah, they turn the film grain on all of a sudden. I don't want the film grain. I don't like it. I'll keep that. Much better. Much better. And this... Okay, wait. Hold on a second.
The meeting room. You can make vid calls from the central table
this?
Or just get the crew together.
What? Okay, are you in my head? She's in my brain. I'm in love. That looks like the Citadel. Wow. You can come up here when you're flying. When you're flying anywhere, you can come up here and you can see space. That's one of the things I'm most excited for in this game, is to be able to just come up here. I don't even know, up here in my room. I don't know where, but wherever I can to
we
see
call
space.
This the research room. You can run research projects
Liam.
And coordinate with the Nexus from
Some
here.
Serious kit over here.
Serious kit over here.
Seems like we're forever racing. but there's always time to check out new toys. Useful ones.
I'm all about what's useful.
Oh, this is. Especially if you grabbed anything from Habitat 7.
I did!
Raw minerals, tech, doesn't matter. The research station will strip that stuff down, give you options.
Options are good. We need more of those. For everybody.
Yeah, well, everybody should be so lucky. This tech is aces. If the best we get is what we make, still the best. Check it out.
Oh boy. Okay. Okay, select research to unlock new blueprints. Select development to craft equipment and nomad upgrades. Using the stuff I've researched. Okay. Weapons, armor, augmentations. Okay, Milky Way, Helios, and Remnant. I don't have Remnant stuff yet. Whoa. Oh. Ooh, that's cool. Okay. Aerials. Ultra rare augmentation. Grenade launcher. Oh my goodness. A vintage heatsink. Nice. I love that they included that. They give you options. You can go to the old heatsink method, or you can stick with the method that they had for a long time, for the last two games. I love it. I love that they give you an option, and you can stick it to whichever weapon you want. Oh, man. Okay. Ooh, rebalance field coils. Whoa. Okay, these are actually pretty good upgrades, you know? It's not just like something stupid. Oh my gosh. Non-shotgun weapons, each projectile is now a sticky grenade. Each pellet on the shotgun is a sticky grenade with lower damage per pellet. Oh my gosh. Oh, and this is not just a grenade launcher. This is an actual... Wow. Can I research these? I want to do a sticky grenade. Can I do sticky grenades? I don't think I... Oh, you need two? I see. I only have 20... Oh, and that's Milky Way, right? Okay. I have a bunch of Helios stuff, though. But no Remnant stuff. Uh-huh. Augmentations. Ricochet system. Oh my goodness. Coolant unit. Increases the clip size by 20% with special ammo is active. Bioconverter. When the current ammo clip is empty, drain 5% of health and refill the... No, why? fires direct line explosive plasma bolts. Charge weapon to fire devastating blast. Shotgun fires direct line explosive plasma bolts, each less damage than normal round. Charge weapons for more blah blah. Concentration module. Plus 2% weapon accuracy when shields are... That's actually really useful, because when your shields are getting low, you're starting to panic, you know? Seeking... Changes weapon projectile to seeking plasma bolts. Can I have that one? I kind of want that one, because I'm having trouble aiming. That's such a cheat. I feel like it's cheating. Let's look at armor. Cat fusion arms. Oh, right. You can change the appearance of your... Ooh. Remnant power sources. It's the supply Angaran hardware. I know what... I actually don't know what Remnant... I think the Remnants are the robots. But I know what an Angaran is. And we haven't met them yet. Center for the Defense of Initiative Angaran Colonies. You are its first and only user. All feedback is welcome. Whoa. Oh, man, that is cool. What is it? Oh. Oh, okay. Why are the helmets separate? Oh, but I don't have the Angara meditation crystal or a cat alloy. Okay, so I can't do it? It's an ultra rare blueprint. Okay, so I have enough freezer's data, but I don't have all the materials. I like this gold looking stuff. Well, can't use it. Well, that's actually... What can I use to break down the information I've already got? You know what I'm saying? What? Wait, what? No. Whoa, I can, what? I can make me some new weapons. Oh my gosh, I'm in love. Melee weapon! Give me a melee weapon! Oh. No! I want to specialize in melee stuff, even though I'm bad at melee. I get freaked out, but... Oh, man. I've been keeping people at mid-range so far. I don't want to be sniper. I kind of like the mid-range. I don't know if I want to be... Alright, let's just do an augmentation. Let's do the seeking plasma. Can I do it? Yes! Oh! I can easily scan and recognize the augmentation in the environment. It will then be available for you to use in developing new items. Yay! And then I don't have to make any more. I can just find them in the field. Okay, well, let's do development. Okie dokie. What? Oh my gosh! It's the Carnifex and the Disciple and the Matic! Oh, and the Fail. No way! What? And the Avenger, the Classic! Classic! Wow, I have enough to do that? Oh, but the Disciple shotgun, though. Meh. I don't have a shotgun yet. That's an Asari weapon. Oh, man. The Matic, I didn't really like the rate of fire on the Matic, if I remember correctly. Phalanx was good. Let's get the shotgun. Oh, shoot. It'll be added to your inventory and available to equip via loadout terminals. I can change the name? We'll just call it the Disciple. Well, boy howdy, thank you. There's nothing to develop? Wait, what? Initiative helmet, whoa. The Pathfinder helmet. I think, is this the one you get for... I need iron and titanium. Chest. Legs. Rare blueprint. That's the N7 sort of. Well, sort not the N7, but it's the same Shepard. It's the same arm that Shepard had. Okay. The Widow, nice. And the shotgun. I'd have got that one. Melee. What about a campfire? What about Omniblade? What? That looks stupid. Okay, well, I did some stuff.